full-time salesman. That's Professor Harold Bill. Harold Bill.
Tell us, what's his line? What's his line?
He's a fake kid. He doesn't know the territory.
What are you talking?
He's a what?
He's a music man. He sells clarinets to the kids in the town with the big trombones and the rat-a-tat drums and the big brass bass, and the piccolo, uniform too, with the shiny gold braid on the coat and a red stripe running to the side.
Well, I don't know much about band, but I do know you can't make a living selling big trombones and rat-a-tat drums. No, sir. A man in pick for a here and there with you, sir.
No, the bell sells bands. Boys, bands. I don't know how he does it, but he lives like a king. And he dallies and he gathers and he plucks and he shines. And when the man dances with certain boys, what else? The piper pays him. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. When the man dances, certainly, boys, what else? The piper pays him.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
But he doesn't own the territory.
Thank you. Excuse me, sir.
Good day.
I'm interested in inquiring your rate for Sunday, if you could accommodate me.
Well, I suppose I better see the man in charge of running rates, then, who's late as usual. Good day.
Children,
Fathers of River City, heed
that morning before it's too late. Watch for the telltale signs of corruption. The minute your son leaves the home, does he rebuckle his knickerbockers? Be loath to be. Is there a nicotine stain on his index finger? A dime novel hidden in the corn crib? Is he starting to memorize jokes from Captain Billy's whiz bang? Are certain words creeping into his conversation? Words like swell. Aha! And so is your old man. Live so, my friends. We got trouble.
I know all about your standards, but we don't. That lady over there is your sister, old man.
Hello, Ezra. I'm having a party on Saturday. Will you please come? I'd especially like it very much if you'd come. Winthrop?
Well, Winthrop, Annabelle's asked me to her party. Are you going or aren't you?
No.
No what?
No, thank you.
You know the little girl's name.
He won't say Annabelle's because of yes, because of Liz. He's ashamed.
We know all about his Liz, Annabelle's. Well, Winthrop?
Oh, Betty won't say it.
No, thank you, Amaryllis.
Amaryllis! Amaryllis! He's crying. Why does he get so mad at people? Just because of his list?
It's not just because of his list, Amaryllis. That's just part of it.
What's the other part?
Well, never mind, dear. It's just that he never talks very much.
Not even to you, dear mother?
No, dear. We all have to be a little patient.
I know. Even though he doesn't ever talk to me, but I do him. Every night of the Evening Star. And you have to say it the very second you see it or it doesn't count. Good night, my mother. Good night, sweetheart.
Well, there, darling, don't cry. You have lots of time. If not Winthrop, there'll be someone else.
Never will end up an old man like you! Oh, I'm sorry, Miss Marion. Can I play my cross hand piece?
May I play my cross hand piece? Yes, you may.
You see, without a sweetheart, you have no one to say goodnight to on the Evening Star.
I know, Amaryllis. But for the time being, just say goodnight by someone. You can put the name in when the right person comes along.
All right. It's better than nothing.
Yes, it is. Now you can play your cross hand piece.
Now I may play my cross hand piece.
Tight, my Yes, our 4th of July exercises, held outside in our lovely town square. Four score. The school board will now present a patriotic tableau. The school board will not present a patriotic tableau. Some dispute about costumes, I suppose. Instead, the wanton e-girls of the local wigwam, Hiawatha, will present a spectacle. My wife. In which my wife, Yalele McKechnie Shin, will take a leading part.
Virtuosos, the cream of every famous band.
76 trombones caught the morning sun, with 110 cornets close at hand. There were more than 1,000 reeds speaking up like weeds. There were horns of every shape and color. There were cummerbund, timpani, and horse platoon. Thundering, thundering all along the way. Double bells, forty guns, and big bassoons. Each bassoon having his big fat say. There were 50-pounder cannon in the battery. Thundering, thundering, all louder than before. Clarinets of every size and trumpeters would improvise a full octave higher than the score.
Ice cream. cream, ice cream. You see, singing is really sustained talking. Now you
ice cream,
and you
ice cream,
and you, sir,
ice cream.
Ladies, from now on, you never see one of these men without the other three.
Professor, you're wrong, why? They've hated each other for 15 years.
Sunday school.
Oh, why that wholesome innocent Sunday school teacher for me?
Oh, that kind of girl's
never is a boy. A girl who trades in all that purity merely wants to be my independence for her security. The only affirmative she will find. First, marching down the aisle, no gold and glorious gleaming pristine goddess. No, sir, for no Diana do I play ball. I can tell you that right now. I snarl, I hiss, how can ignorance be compared to bliss? I spark, and I fizz, for the lady who knows what time it is. I cheer, and I rave, for the virtue I'm too late to say. Beside of a wiser girl for me.
Reasonable, you can guarantee. She had a gold ring on the tender eye and a silver
What?
No apologies, no explanations, please. I'll only be in town a short while, and the sadder but wiser girl for me.
Will you please make your selection and leave?
Oh, I have.
Well, what would you like to take out?
The librarian! The librarian. Aggies, a dozen Kiwis, and one big glass with an American flag. I think I'll drop them.
No!
Shh!
Librarian.
specimen has an unusual tone of voice, which I have never
you
heard
of. You can't hoodwink me, you ragamuffin! Soliciting is statutory in this county. Malfeasance without a permit. Why haven't you been down City Hall with your references?
Mayor Shin, your hand. Oh, no.
What? What?
That spread of your little finger? That's hereditary.
Oh, it is.
What does that mean? That means that your son's little finger is perfectly situated to operate the spit valve in a B-flat flugelhorn.
Is that good?
Good. Mayor Shin, that means that America has finally produced an artist who can flugel-a-minute waltz in 50 seconds.
How can I get one of those forms?
Sign here, Mayor Shin. That'll be $17 in court fee.
Yes, sir. To think I could have missed this hole. I haven't got any son! You unscrupulous flew by night! You unflupulous! You meet out of City Hall with your references at 3 o'clock!
You mean this afternoon?
I couldn't make myself any plainer if I was a Quaker on his day off!
Charming and lovely as yourself. Good evening to you, Whitaker.
1890 to 1910. It's a large green volume with black corners. You won't have to say anything. I've written it all down. Thank you, dear.
Now what are you up to? We need books in the third of the night.
I have a feeling your journal may help me poke some large holes in the professor's claims.
Well, I give up. At your age, if you don't mind me asking, what type of white knight do you expect to come riding along?
Well, I'm not waiting for Luther Premier, who backs me into the ancient history shelf every time he comes into the library.
He does.
Or Ed Gamage, and that buggy of his with the removable back seat. But I'm not waiting for a man in white shining armor either.
Papa, the Wells Fargo wagon's just coming up from the depot.
The Wells Fargo wagon!
A likely
streets. Get acquainted with your instruments. And remember the minuet in G. La-di-da-di-da-di-da-di-da. La-di-da. La-di-da.
It's you all the way into town.
Why, you!
We'd rather do it in front of you, Ben.
Do what? Never mind!
Sunita's afraid of you, but I ain't. I think you'd be ashamed to have your own daughter afraid of you.
I'll warn you once more. If I catch you touching my daughter, I'll by God horsewhip you till hell won't have again.
Now, George.
Not one poop out of you, madam.
I think he means pink.
Get out of this public building.
I got as much right in this public building as anybody.
Right? How do you get any right around here aiding and abetting the swindling activities of that spellbinding symbol salesman? You know what I see written all over you? Reform school. Now get out. Get out, you wild kid, yeah.
Go, please. It's Captain, it's like you that make blood in the marketplace. It does.
You watch your phraseology, young lady. Now go home. Delaney.
George, I don't...
You tend to your dance.
My dance?
I'll look after Zanita, taking up with wild kids from the wrong side of town.
Mr. Mayor, I can just get you to understand.
Well, you can't. And thanks for nothing. I read that book you gave me from cover to cover for a whole week now. I didn't find a thing.
Mr. Mayor, if you please.
I'll settle your cash as soon as I get these premises off my oldest girl. Yes.
All right, fine. But in the meantime, I want you to know I'm vouching for Tommy Gilas. Why, that boy has supported every young man in this town. You'll be lining up to shake his hand by the time his band plays his first concert.
By the time this band plays its first concert, the individual members will have to foregather in wheelchairs on account of their broken legs and tripping over their beards. And I'll tell you another thing, my feathered young fine. Never mind!
Professor Hale, I think that Mayor Shin has behaved abominably. And I think it is wonderful of me coming to Tommy's defense.
Oh, that's great.
Yes, it was.
Oh, no. A man cannot dodge the issue every time a little personal risk is involved. What does the poet say? The coward dies 1,000 deaths, the hero only 500. And I'm afraid Mayor Shin was already quite upset on account of the billiard parlor, and... Oh, I'm sure a recommendation from the musical authorities such as yourself would help, but I couldn't think of asking you to do a thing like that.
Why, Professor Hill?
You would?
Well, I'd be glad to. I just wish I was a little more informed. You see, I've been wanting to talk to you about Winthrop's cornet.
Ah, yes. Mother of pearl keys.
Yes, I'm sure it's fine. It's just that, well, he never touches it. The first week or so, he made a few, experimental blats, I guess you would say.
Yes, blats.
Yes, and he sings the minuet and gidina almost constantly.
La di da di da di da di da,
la di da, la di da.
But he never touches the cornet.
Well.
He tells me it isn't necessary. He tells me about some fix system that if he thinks the minuet and G, he doesn't have to bother with any of the notes. Now, Professor.
Miss Mary. The think system is a revolutionary method, I'll admit, but so was Galileo's conception of the heavens, and Columbus's conception of the egg, or globe, and Bach's conception of a well-tempered clavichord. Now, I cannot discuss these matters with you in public right now, but if you'd allow me to call, when might I call?
Why, any night this week. Silver shoes.
completely deputized.
Why, congratulations. Now, of course, you won't get my references, but you see, I've been buying time or two this week to give them to you, and every time you seem to get on the subject somehow. Now, I have in my hotel room. Take you by the minute.
Sorry, but I have to come along with you this time.
Of course. Let me just see if I have my key here. What's this? Testimonial from Madame Rini, the only female bassoon player on the Red Path circuit. Her stage name, of course. She was originally from Moline. Lida Rose Quackenbush.
Can I take a look at that, please?
Oh, you won't forget the name. Lida Rose. Same as in the old song. Lida Rose, I'm home again, Rose, to get the sun back in the sky. Lida Rose, I'm home again, Rose, about a thousand kisses shy. Ding, dong, ding, I can hear the chapel bells chime. Ding, dong, ding, at the least suggestion, I'll pop the question. Lida Rose, I'm home again, Rose, without a sweetheart to my name. Lida Rose, now everyone knows that I'm hoping you're the same. So here is my love song, not fancy or fine. Lida Rose, oh, won't you be mine? Lida Rose, oh, Lida Rose, oh, Lida Rose.
Gary, Indiana, Gary, Indiana, Gary, Indiana.
I'll be back in a minute. I just have to go tell Amaryllis my frog. Oh, leave the dishes, Mama. I'll do them. Don't you have to change for the social?
Oh, there's time later.
Wouldn't.
true that you've... Is it true that you've had a... What I'm trying to say is it really true that you've developed a leg system?
A thing system. Oh, it's really quite simple. Why? This simple as whistling. You see, nobody has to show you how to use your lips while whistling. You just think the tune up here and it comes out through here. Try it yourself before asking the question.
I take your word.
Sit down.
Are all music teachers as dense as I am?
All music teachers?
Well, I dare say you do meet dozens, even 100.
Well?
Have they all been as fascinated with the think system as I have?
Some more, some less. Why, one young lady thought of the same system before I even came to her town. She showed me a few refinements.
Oh, I see.
I said something wrong?
Well, please don't let me keep you, Professor Hill. You must have many more important things to do than to explain the think system to me.
Can't think along.
Oh, that must be very dull company for a man of your experience.
Now, say, where'd you get an idea like that?
One hears rumors of a traveling salesman.
Now, Miss Mary, you must believe everything you hear. After all, one does hear rumors about librarians.
And I suppose you're referring to Uncle Maddie?
Uncle Maddie?
Mr. Madison. My father's best friend. No matter what they say, he left me an assured job so that Mother and Winthrop and I would have some sort of security. Now surely you don't believe—
Of course not. But what is it you think that starts those kind of rumors?
Narrow-mindedness. Jealousy. Jealousy mostly, I guess.
Exactly. And jealousy is what starts rumors about a traveling salesman. What have you heard?
Oh, nothing about you personally, just generally.
What have you heard, generally?
Well, of course, it stands to reason that jealousy and disappointment can lead to, and well, take you, for instance, and your attentions to customers, and well, music teachers, they might be misinterpreted, mightn't they? No, honestly, mightn't they?
Well.
And so you say that if another salesman were jealous of something, well, then they could be downright lies, now couldn't they?
What could?
Well, rumors and things.
Why, of course.
So you say you should never believe anything you hear. I mean, unless you discuss things.
Miss Barry, I would be happy to discuss anything in the world with you. Couldn't we do it sitting down? You do sit, your knees bend and all.
We could sit on the porch steps.
Or we could sit in the hall log over at the footbridge.
Oh, I can't. I've never been to the footbridge with a man in my life.
Just to talk.
I've got to dress for the social.
Then meet me there in 15 minutes.
Oh, I just can't. Please, maybe some other time. Perhaps tomorrow.
My dear little librarian, pile up enough tomorrows and one day you'll find you collected nothing but a lot of empty yesterdays. I don't know about you, but I'd like to make today a worth remembering.
Oh, so would I.
The footbridge then? 15 minutes?
15 minutes.
Thank you.
the sociable.
Yeah.
Oh, here's most of the dough. I got Tommy collecting. He's keeping the kids together, please. Tend to hold up the practice down at the lumberyard.
Great. We'll get the rig.
I got it.
What time is the freight go?
9:40 at the junction.
9:40? It isn't even 8:30 yet.
Well, if you want to turn all around here and get yourself caught in a bunny trap, you go way ahead, buddy.
Mars, don't worry. I'll meet you at the hotel in plenty of time. Miss Mary, you're late.
You said 15 minutes.
What I meant was, I'd say you're late by about 23 years. This long to get to the footbridge of the fella?
Well, if you want to know the truth, it was almost longer.
Oh?
Halfway here. I nearly decided to turn back. I guess I'm not the first to find it easier to think clearly when not under the spell of your salesmanship.
Now, Miss Mary, surely you don't think I've been selling you anything?
No. You've given me something. And that's why I came.
I don't recall.
Yes, you have. Something beautiful. And that's why I came. Hopefully you won't expect me to think that you will stay. One can't expect a traveling salesman to stay put. Now I know you've had many ports of call, and that there will be many more. But that doesn't mean that I shouldn't be grateful for what you left behind for.
Mary, resigning without my commission.
Craig, you can't get anywhere out here in the footbridge.
There's
a spot over at Madison Picnic Park near the Social Bowl that makes this foot booth look like an old lady's home. Now beat it. Go get the ring. Never a dull moment in the music business. Where were we?
Well, you were about to tell me what I don't know about you.
Yes. Well, we don't really have to go into that right now, do we?
No, we don't. Or ever, for that matter. The librarian hasn't felt like doing much research lately. But she did plenty before you came.
Oh, what about?
Professor Harold Hill, Gary Conservatory of Music, gold medal class of O5. Harold, there was no Gary Conservatory in O5.
Why, there certainly...
Because the town wasn't built until O6. See you at the social hall.
You knew all the time?
Ever since July 7th, 3 days after you came. See, I tore this page of the Indiana Journal. It was originally intended to be used against you, but I give it to you with all of my heart.
But if you knew, why, you little...
Took my place as the one and only bass, and I hopped up and down the square.
Good night, my someone. Good night, my love.
Well, 110 cornets have played the air.
There has been any band, and there never will be any.
if you don't hunt this man down like a mad dog, there won't be any Harold Hill either. He'll be on the next train out of town.
Now do you believe me?
Well, what are we waiting for?
I want my money back.
Money back? We want his hide.
Yeah.
And when you find him, bring him to town square. After him. Try the low roads. Look by the creek. Try the mill. Back of the privy.
Four score. Ah, virgin.
you ask, Ryan. The sword of retribution has cut down Professor Harold Hill. And if there are those who are collecting tar and melting feathers, I will not say them nay.
Well, I should think some of you ought to forget our everlasting I was stubbornness, chip on the shoulder arrogance long enough to remember what River City was like before Harold Hill arrived. Well, do you remember? Do you? Surely some of you ought to be grateful for what he brought to this city. And if so, you should want to admit it.
You're wasting a great deal of time here. If anyone doesn't think that this man, Hill, should be tarred and feathered, let him stand now. Gillelee, sit down! And look at the rest of you standing there like a coat of Shropshire shit. Have you forgotten how you paid for expensive uniforms, technical instruction books, and high-priced band instruments? All under the clear understanding and warranty that your children would play in a band. Well, where's the band?